The F-35 is one of the most advanced fighter jets in the world, boasting stealth, sensor fusion, and networked warfare capabilities. As of February 2025, 20 countries have purchased or placed confirmed orders for the Lockheed Martin F-35s. So other than the US, 19 nations have committed to this fighter jet. Lockheed Martin has delivered over 1,100 F-35s to customers worldwide, with 110 jets delivered in 2024 alone. But several countries, especially the Europeans, may now be reassessing their decision following the emergence of a significant rift with Washington over their positions towards the ongoing Russian-Ukrainian war. There are concerns that just like threats to cut off Ukraine's access to the Starlink satellite network and limiting access to targeting data for precision-guided weapons, Washington could disable the F-35s. There is much speculation regarding the presence of a discrete kill switch in the fighter that can be remotely activated, but there is more to it. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the US can disable F-35s even without the so-called kill switch. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The kill switch myth centers on the belief that the U.S. can immobilize an F-35, whether in flight or on the ground, by simply flipping a switch, effectively neutralizing an ally's air power at will. This concept, reminiscent of a sci-fi thriller, suggests a high-tech safeguard designed to enforce compliance. Critics argue that such a mechanism would compromise national sovereignty of clients, leaving their Air Force vulnerable to foreign control. However, despite the fascinating narrative, there is no evidence or technical foundation to support this claim. In the same vein, it has to be clarified that there is no certainty of its absence. F-35 is a deeply integrated system with over 8 million lines of code, which is not shared with customers. European media has been abuzz with speculation and concern over the kill switch. German newspaper Bild has been a key voice in this discussion, reporting on March 9th that German policymakers are increasingly worried about this. Former president of the Munich Security Conference Foundation, Wolfgang Ischinger, shared his insights regarding the future of Germany's F-35 procurement plans. He stated, "If we have to fear that the US could do with future German F-35s what they are currently doing with Ukraine, we could consider terminating the contract. Germany has 35 F-35s on order, and it is set to be delivered to the Luftwaffe starting in 2026 as part of an 8.3 billion euro deal. Concerns regarding the limited autonomy that operators of the F-35 will have were highlighted beyond Germany, with the defense analyst Richard Aboulafia speaking to the London-based Financial Times, observing that although the existence of a kill switch has not been confirmed, if you postulate the existence of something that can be done with a little bit of software code, it exists. Britain has committed on a £9.1 billion deal for 48 F-35s, with 36 to be delivered by 2025. In response to European media reports, Lockheed Martin and several governments have pushed back on the idea that joint strike fighters have any kind of a discrete kill switch. The truth is that a dedicated kill switch isn't necessary to prevent foreign F-35s from operating as intended. Simply cutting off support would achieve the same outcome, perhaps not immediately, but soon enough. Without access to US-controlled maintenance, logistics systems, and computer networks, any F-35 fleet would rapidly become ineffective. Any jets that managed to keep flying for a short period would do so with severely diminished capabilities. Joachim Schranzhofer, the head of communications at German defense company Hensoldt, mentioned to the local media outlet Bild, "The kill switch in the F-35 is more than just a rumor. but it's much easier to use the mission planning system. Then the plane stays on the ground. Analysts have specifically pointed out that the Autonomic Logistics Information System, ALIS, which is heavily centralized in the US, could potentially be used to ground the fighters. ALIS has critical mission data and flight routes, without which the F-35 will be handicapped and mostly likely unusable. Justin Bronk, a senior research fellow at the Royal United Services Institute, observed that most European militaries depend heavily on the US for communication support, for electronic warfare support, and for ammunition resupply in any serious conflict, which made the need for a kill switch redundant. Since the 1980s, the United States has imposed notably strict restrictions on how its fighter aircraft can be used by foreign clients, a concern that has been widely discussed for decades. In early 2020, former Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad observed regarding the restrictions imposed on the Royal Malaysian Air Force's operations of the country's F-18 fighters. "We cannot program the plane for any attacks against other countries without getting the programming done by Americans. So although the planes are very good, in terms of performance, have very powerful engines, but we cannot program the plane by ourselves. You have to refer to the United States for putting the program for any raid on foreign countries, for example. So our planes were costly, we have them. We can fly them at air shows, but we cannot use them to fight any other country because we don't get the source code." In February 2025, former Indian Air Force Air Marshal Anil Chopra observed Washington's tendency to exert pressure and abandon allies when its own interests diverge with theirs were leading factors that ensured Delhi would not consider the F-35. Restrictions on access to software codes, along with limits on where the fighters could be operated and for what roles, were significant factors that deterred India from seriously considering offers to purchase the F-16 or F-18 in the past. While these types of concerns have usually not been raised by NATO members due to their greater access to software codes and common strategic objectives with Washington, the recent crack in relations could result in a paradigm shift in this regard. It remains to be seen how these considerations affect the F-35 sales in the coming years. On a side note, policymakers in France are in a much easier position since the country uses its own Dassault Rafale fighter.